Cam asks on the tails of this question, why did the FDA have a value for vitamin A for pregnancy at much higher at 8,000 IU than the IOM in the past? I have no idea. I mean, I just said I don't pay any attention to the FDA. That's a research project, but like, look, what I do know is that the concerns around pregnancy for vitamin A are that in the first weeks of pregnancy, 10,000 IU and higher has been associated with birth defects. That was one study in 1995 that was a prospective study, which is higher quality, but contradicted all the retrospective studies that came to the opposite conclusion. So there's not good consensus on the data. There's just moderately justifiable paranoia about the possibility that you could cause a birth defect. And there were, you know, if you go back to that 1995 study, somewhere in the Weston A. Price Journal, I wrote about this, probably Nutrition for Fetal Development. There's a sidebar on it. If you Google my name, with Nutrition for Fetal Development, it's probably there. There were like 7 or 8 letters to the editor about why that study had a bunch of problems with it. Like the data just didn't make sense. So the basis for restricting A in pregnancy, if that might be what you're referring to, is it's a theoretical concern that doesn't have a lot of data to support it. Then again, I see no reason why someone needs necessarily 10,000 IU or more going into the first 8 weeks of pregnancy. I mean, so like if you eat liver once or twice a week, you're not getting more than that. If you took a half a teaspoon of cod liver oil every day, you're not getting more than that. If you eat eggs and dairy every day, you're not getting more than that. So I would not supplement with 10,000 IU and higher vitamin A going into pregnancy because, not because I'm super paranoid and there's good data justifying the restriction, but just because the theoretical concern outweighs the lack of theoretical benefit in most cases for most women. Now, if that woman is trying to get pregnant, but her serum retinol is low and her eyes are dry and her night vision is bad and she has hyperkeratosis, then you bend the rule a little bit because you have an obvious justification to get her vitamin A levels up. But if there's no such problem and there's no reasonable theoretical benefit of taking 20,000 IU leading into pregnancy, why would you do it? It's just, you know, speculation versus speculation, but like, why not pave the middle ground of what you would reasonably get from food?